Hello guys and welcome everyone on the Weapon Reviews episode number 4 tonight with the MP38-40 Betrayal and the gun I'm holding, the ASW Betrayal. I'm your host for tonight, MythSky, and I'm here with Zetor.
Hello. That's normal.
So yeah, the Betrayal guns this week, what do you think before we start with the stream?
Two amazing guns.
I think I can agree with you on that. We'll show you guys later on why we feel that way about it. But I think most people will realize it pretty soon if you haven't realized already with the random key packs that have been dropping for 1 and 3 days on, I believe, even last week on this one. So yeah, for tonight we'll also be raffling the gun I'm holding, the ASW Betrayal, for 15 days, along with a full iron set for 7 days. So that's quite a sweet pack. And me and Zeta will each have 3 keys to that. And we'll raffle them alongside the event. The event goes as follows. We're first going to go do some testings with the gun in a practice channel. So we'll start off with the MP38-40 Betrayal. We'll just do that in the... we'll just do some range tests with the scope. We'll do some... move shot test and stuff like that, no scope test. And after that we'll do the first giveaway key, we'll move on to some in-game some games actually on cold case to test the guns like 2 or 3. We'll give away another gun and then we'll round off the stream with an in-game event, and after the in-game event the last giveaway. If we have more time left we may even do 2 in-game events, so that pretty much depends. So, you're ready, Zeter?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Well then, let's go to the practice channel. And Mike, as you were saying, I actually tried to become a Twitch partner like 2 months ago, but I got rejected because you need a stable 500 views. And as you know, with AVA, that's probably never gonna happen. So, it's hard.
500 is impossible.
I'll just create a random password. I don't know what I typed, so I'll just invite you. Alright, let's go with the first gun, the MP38-40. Before we start, let's actually show the gun comparisons on screen. Should be good to do. First of all, MP38-40, I compared it to the Chris Death, which I should equip, so let me do that in the meantime. As you can see, stat differences are displayed on screen. And yeah, there's more damage, a lot more actually. Range is a little bit less, but since it also has a little bit less ROF, it is quite even to the Chris Dead, but I believe the DPS is slightly higher with this gun. What you do notice, and we'll see straight away, is that the aim is quite big, but it's still really good. And then we have the ASW. Compared to the regular gun, yeah, there are a lot of differences. That's the main reason why we chose this gun. It is like the only really buffed gun in this Betrayal series. And oh god, it's good. And the thing that it doesn't display in the stats is that it has a static crosshair. So when you're running around, it also has a crosshair. So that's nice.
Yeah, it's really nice. I compared the MP38 with the old MP38 from the Red Ticket Shop, just to see if it was a difference between that one and the new one, but it isn't. Only two extra bullets.
Well then, let's go.
Yeah.
So we're first going to do some recoil tests on ranges of 10 and 20 meters on cannon. And we'll try and do some other things with the MP38. And then we'll move on to the scope. Okay, so this is 10 meters. This is 20. So let's first do it while standing up. You do the main gun, I'll do the crusade.
Reload! Okay. So normal at that one.
Yeah, let's go. I started a little bit too high, but the recoil pattern seems about the same, although yours seems to have a bit more side-to-side recoil.
Yeah, it has a lot of side-to-side, but it don't really make an impact when you're actually in-game.
Okay, let's move walls and let's try again, this time while ducking. You ready? Well, you can see the difference quite good here. A lot more side-to-side recoil.
Yeah.
I don't know what's happening lately, but... anyways, let's try it while jumping. My ping's still going down, but I'll be fine. For this gun, slightly good. For the MP38, let me just show you that. The aim slightly goes bigger, but it is still not like a big problem.
The crosshair is big on this gun, but still, it's easy to see where the middle is.
Yep. Yeah, it's indeed fairly big. Alright, let's move on to range. I'll just use the I'll just switch to the Chris Death again. Okay, so range at 20 meters, and we aim at this spot. You ready? Let's go. Okay, that quite tells the story.
To the left.
Yeah, indeed. That was quite sick. Okay, let's move next wall. This time duck. Same height. Okay, and spray. This is doesn't seem as bad for you, does it?
No, it's they are like the bullets land close to each other. It pulls up to the left, but that's very easy to compensate.
Huh? So yeah, I think we can conclude the gun doesn't really drop as much on range as it comes to the bullet spray. I think you see the difference a bit more with the Chris Death. So, yeah, it's quite the good gun.
Yeah.
Even with just spraying, we haven't even displayed the CQC combat. Okay, and anything left you want to review about this gun before we move on to the next?
No, not really. Like, I just feel it's a solid gun, but we're gonna see if I can live up to that word soon when we try to shoot at other people.
Let me just try and do a fast one with spraying and one with a bit controlling the spray. I'll just aim at this height. I'll do both of the walls. So that's full spray. And this is while I control it. So there you go, a lot of difference. When you control it, it is really close together, and this is actually really good.
Yeah.
Control. Okay, let's move on to the ASW then. As you can see straight away, the 9 ammo, and what you also notice, that it opens, I'm not sure what it is, it seems like a range sight or something?
Like the proximity thing you have in the alien movie, kind of.
Well, to be fair, the first time I used that gun and I saw this, it really got on my nerves, but I got past that point. And as you can see now, you actually have an aim which varies when you crouch. So that already shows if you stand up, you have more chance on crouching and then hitting your shot. Although that was really far off. No scope is fairly decent on this gun, but it's no TPG. Let's actually try a no scope test. We should get a central point to aim at though. Let's see if we can find any. Oh wait, we can just use this wall. We start viewing from here. This should be about, I think this is like 15 meters maybe?
To that wall is 13, 15 is over there. Okay.
Then we'll aim at this height. I'll just use a knife. Okay, we'll just aim at it from here. And let's see how close the no scopes end together.
it's not super reliable. It's not.
No, to be fair, it is not as bad as I expected. But this is of course when crouching. When you stand up, it'll be a lot worse. We can turn around though. Let's try it now while standing up, same height. Let's see, that's here. Yeah, it should be fine. Okay, let's try now. As you can see, that pretty much goes everywhere. It'll be very hard to hit a guy like this, and this is even closer by, and you can see the results are even worse than the 50 meter ones while actually ducking. So, quite the difference. Just to answer your question, Yanomami VNL, VZNL, or, yeah. And ZL it is, sorry. Yeah, you can view both sides of the screen on multi-twitch. .com or TV?
I think it's .tv.
Multi.
Both names, yes. Yeah. Slash this guy's name slash my name.
So that's how you can get the dual stream if you want. Okay, let's take a look at the gun while scoped in. This quite similar to most of the guns. Shaking goes up. But the thing that you do notice with this gun, it doesn't move shot as much as the regular FR F2, for example, or for the DSR. I have the Neon with me. Let me show the no scopes with that for a bit. I'll just use the same height, see that we can compare it to the FR no scopes. So that is slightly worse, but while ducking it should be better. FR ducking no scopes are actually fairly reliable below 5 meters, but it's about the same with the Betrayal. Betrayal seems slightly better actually. But let's do the move shotting now then. I'll just use this wall as a navigation point about this height. And I'll run, and I won't shift walk, and then I'll try to shoot at the top. As you can see, they don't all hit. See, a lot of shots actually land next to the wall, and that's because this gun doesn't have as much no scope. If you actually go with the slow walk in the end, then it'll be much more reliable. I'll try it on this wall this time. As you can see, a little bit of shift walking makes it a lot less worse, and actually fairly decent to move shot with, but you have to do the strafe at the end with the shift key or while ducking. That works the same as I can show you.
Shift the millisecond before you press the trigger.
Yeah, pretty much. So there you go. Changing magazines. So that is the main difference. You have to like either break shot or shift walk while you try to move shot, otherwise you won't really hit your shots, but that's pretty much the same as with the FR. The only difference is that, for example, with the DSR you can actually just run and shoot and not worry about missing shots. So those are the main things to cover. You want to try and do jump shots and see how bad it is?
Oh yeah, sure.
I'm quite curious to see. Let's use around this height as a navigation point if we can manage that. From 10 meters, let's say.
Jump shots and no scopes are pretty similar. Like, you have these small, tiny red markets outside of the center.
Okay, jump shots were a complete disaster.
You're gonna hit within that, at least.
Well, not even. I mean, I was aiming here, and bullets ended all the way up here at the wall. I mean, jump shot is terrible.
The dots, like the area gets even bigger. If you just jump.
Yeah, if you jump, it gets even bigger, so you have to duck and no-scope if you... Well, that can still work, like 5 to 10 meters. 10 meters, you gotta be lucky. 5 meters, it's quite solid. And jump shot is just a no-go with this gun. You will miss every single shot with it. So I think that are the most things we have to cover for this gun. Are there any other things you want to go over?
No, not really. I just feel like this feels so much smoother than the normal ASW. I don't know if it's just a mind trick, but...
Yeah.
Faster also, and also I like to have the scopes. I like the scope better on it.
Yeah, the scope really looks cool. The scope itself is also quite fine. What you may want to know is that this gun is moddable. You have a basic scope, you can put on a precision scope or quick scope, and we put in the precision scope. At least I did. Don't know what you did. You're using basic scope.
Oh yeah, I'm not sure actually.
Did you even mod it?
Yeah.
Then you must have the precision scope.
Sharpshooter scope also.
A precision or sharpshooter, it's called either that.
Sharpshooter, I don't think you have that on the normal one.
I just know that there's two scopes, one dual faced one and one single scope, the quick scope. And I'm using the dual faced one.
Yeah, I have two faces also.
Yep. And yeah, as a lot of people are saying, this gun, the ROF slightly differs when you no-scope, where you go for quick switches or not. Let's actually do that difference, Zeter. You reload the gun, I'll do it without quick switching, you'll do with quick switching, and you'll call out when you have no ammo left, okay?
Okay.
You ready?
Okay.
Let's go.
I'm done.
Yeah, I have two ammo left. So, that's the difference. Two ammo in over 9. And that's quite a lot.
Yeah.
And for the people who are just wondering, seeing me jump around doing the scope sways, you should see my mouse. I'm barely even moving it. I think I'm using like 1/4 of my mouse pad to do this. Maybe 1/3. Don't need much. But yeah, I think that's it for the ASW Betrayal. As you can see, it is quite good for moveshotting. If you break shot a little bit with it, it's doable. And as we also already saw with the MP38/40 Betrayal, it's just an overall good gun stat-wise, and also when you control it a little bit. But you'll see with the games that we're gonna play now, how fast they're gonna drop, and with the MP38 you'll need like 3 to 4 bullets to actually drop a guy, and that is actually not much at all. So, let's go there then.
The squad leader has changed.
So for the people just tuning in, we are now going to move to some in-game rooms. You can join that. It'll just be 5v5 cold case. No rewards will be connected to it though. We'll play 2 games now to display the differences between the guns. And after that, we'll do the first giveaway for tonight for the ASW Betrayal for 15 days. This one. And the full line set for 7 days. Do you want to make the rooms either, or should I?
You can make it.
Okay then. Yeah, it's just cold case, there's not gonna be a password on it, it's not needed whatsoever. Cold case all the way down though. Wait, this is a 16 man room, my bad. I have to put it at 10, otherwise it's not good. 10. We don't have to do teams, so once more, room number 2. Sorry about that.
What gun do you want to start with? The pointman, or?
I'll start with the pointman, sure.
Okay.
Oh, great, I'm getting that buck again. I just gotta do that. Don't worry, I won't start yet. We have three more spots, so if anyone wants to join, you can go now. You can still join in. I have to start again. Let's just wait for one more and then start.
Yeah.
There we go. Let's go. So more people can join, but this is more of a fun... yeah, let's just keep it at 100, sorry. Let's go. Alright then, so first of all, the MP38.
Oh, it's a lot of appointments.
Yep. I think a lot of people actually have this gun for a couple of days. Okay, so in range, I hit one bar on you. I hit hot guy once. That were three bars. Aim slightly weak though. I wanna get you, Zeter. Oh, oh.
Oh.
Easy step. No, oh, I have no ammo. Okay, now I can show the crit death now. That's good. Yeah, for the people just tuning in, when we're gonna go host the giveaway after those two games, the only requirement is to follow the channel, so make sure to do that. We are currently at 961 followers, so we're getting close to that 1000. Probably three more streams. No, Zitor.
Oh!
You got cracked in.
Yeah.
And I got dropped really fast. Yeah, your team seems to be slightly better at this point. Damn, that top guy drops fast. I don't like him.
Oh no!
That's right. That was quite a fast drop, I must say. Did I chest shot headshot you on that range?
Yeah, I have no idea. So fast.
That was still three shot. The guy was slightly tanked. Yeah, as you can see, the gun has fairly good damage, even at a little bit of range. Oh god, Peter's gonna try. You missed. You missed again. No! Damn it. No, I'm using the same amount of sense. There you go.
No!
Here we go. Damn, I missed you. That was a cool shot though.
Oh, I miss.
Yeah, you missed a lot.
I'll be there.
No. Ah, you think. Reload. But I hit you a bit low. I switch too fast. Okay, back to the appointment. And that didn't go well.
The command has been hit!
I keep falling into his aim.
Oh!
Might have got you. Too many scopes at this point. Let me use the Chris Dead for a bit and show the difference. Damn it! Don't camp seater!
I have a scope!
So doesn't mean you have to camp.
I didn't have time to. There's people everywhere.
Yeah, I noticed. Only scopes.
Oh, he tagged.
A fairly fast drop. Nah, still got me. Didn't hit you in the head. But I think we're gonna lose this. Let's just call it on the TZC, shall we? Or not? Teammate coming close.
Oh, from sight.
Yeah.
How many kills did you get this?
A lot.
Operation success.
Team mid carry. Oh, we won. GG. So, yeah, as you can see, both of the guns, well, still, Chris Dat has been OP ever since it came out, so. But the MP38 Stoke 40 is quite a match for it. To be fair, well, the aim is slightly bigger, so both are good. I personally like the gun more, since it's just a normal gun already. It just looks better. Reload animation's quite sweet. It just handles nicely. Good headshot. Good range damage. I really like it. What do you think about the scope, Seater?
Yeah, it's amazing. I like it a lot.
Well, that's basically
I like the normal ASW, but somehow I like this one.
Normal ASW is fine, but yeah.
This one, you have the sharpshooter scope. On the normal ASW is like sharpshooter 2 or something, and that magnification is more, so
yeah, for this it's just about right.
I don't like, this is the perfect distance for this zoom on this one.
But yeah, as Zeter said, if Zeter likes a gun and Zeter says the gun's good, it must be good. Alright, let's go then. I'll review the ASW and now Zeta will go with the appointment. And after that, we'll host the first giveaway of tonight. Also, if you guys have any input on the event itself, just make sure to let us know that in the chat, so we can actually take that into consideration. Damn. You four-shot at me, I think?
I don't know how many bullets.
I think I saw four.
Oh!
Let's try. Yeah. Whoa, this guy. You tanked! Green is carrying. Okay, we're quite being pushed to the base, so not much to review for me yet.
One's poking me now.
Jesus Christ, okay, no scope's not reliable.
Not going too well now.
Yeah, same.
I like that you're far in the... back in the base, because you will expect me around all the corners I make.
Pistol shotting. Yeah. So, not much to do for yet for reviewing. It's a bit hard now. Really get away here. I can still see him through here. Jeez.
Now we can get up some base.
Yeah, finally. Wow, this guy. Okay, it does no scope.
Was it no scope?
Yeah. Getting outplayed quite severely at this point though. Okay, maybe no scopes aren't as bad. So just set. There were two guys of my team behind me. They didn't cover me. I figured they had me, so I didn't look back.
Never try to.
Yeah. Oh my god. No! Oh, you haunted me this time. So it does one hit on scopes, at least headshot. Oh my. I don't like this. I can't do anything at this point. Let's just compare it to the regular FR.
Oh,
I'm more used to the Apara though. Damn you, Zitor!
How do you know it's me?
You're the only one with that skin. Wow, he silenced me.
No! Good save.
Wow. I'm just getting out-camped everywhere. Close to GG yet? I'll go back to the ASW for the last couple of kills. Hopefully I can make those.
One more kill.
Operation failure. Turn to main base.
Tried to go for no scope on me, that didn't work, but yeah, the gun's quite good. But you need to adjust to it, especially if you're used to like the FR or any other gun. It behaves a bit differently, so you gotta get used to it. But overall, it's quite good.
Yeah.
So what do you think about the appointment?
I like it. It's not the best appointment gun in the game, but it's good enough. Like I could use it in whatever situation.
Okay, let's just move out of the room now. We're now streaming for about half an hour, so just doing an in-game event straight after then ending would be too soon, so I think we'll do two in-game events then, as just like last week. But before we do that, let's get ready for the first giveaway for tonight, for this ASW Betrayal for 15 days, along with a full line set for 7 days. For the people who just tuned in, keep in mind, all you gotta do is to follow the channel and to watch the stream, of course. That's all. Alright, Zizar, are you ready? Your harmonica ready?
Give me 1 second.
Alright.
Better and...
I'll just get it up too then.
Okay, let's see, it's gonna be better now.
Well, that's indeed a lot better. Alright then, first giveaway. Harmonica ready?
Yep.
The first winner for tonight is Shrek565. Congrats! So yeah, you win the first giveaway key for tonight. I have 2 more, and Zito will have 3 more at this point. He hasn't raffled them so far.
And, first winner in my stream is HateUCCE.
Who?
HateUCZE.
Interesting name. I don't know the guy though. Alright, in the meantime, let me just send you your key, Shrek. It'll be able to make use of it. As we said, giveaway gun, ASW Betrayal, 15 days, along with the full line set for 7 days. Let me just link you up. Alright, key's been sent, so that's arranged. And did you send the key as well, Zeter, or not yet?
I'm gonna send it soon.
Oh, okay then, no worries. Okay, shall we move on to the in-game event then, the first out of two, or you want to do something else first?
No, let's get right into it.
Okay, now I'll ask the people on the stream, let us know which map you want for the in-game event. We won't put a password on the room, and...
Should we do it like first event, your chat makes the call, Second event, my chat makes the call.
Okay, makes sense. So now for people watching my stream on MythSky, first come, first served, the first people that calls out the map, that's the map we're gonna play. Let's... Oh, that was fast. Shrek again, E-Bolt. There you go. So E-Bolt is going to be the map then. Let's see, it is under military drill. There we go. So I'll just call the room name ESL event, because that's how most people recognize the in-game events I host. Keep in mind that this event actually does come with rewards, and that is 5k in-game euros for whoever's playing.
Yeah.
So there we go, room number 19. Two people already beat you.
Oh, wow. Well, I guess that's the guy that won the code in my stream.
Who?
Hate you.
Oh, it was hate you. I heard something completely different.
Uh-huh.
So that explains. At least the room is filling up a bit more, so that's good.
Yeah, I got a little bit bad back.
It's already full.
So, what gun are you going
with? Oh, wait, Zeraton. I remember that name. Don't you know who that is?
Who?
Zeraton.
No.
That is Mr. Corzy.
Uh-huh.
I'm not sure if we should let him play. Should we kick him?
Sure.
Okay, then. We've got a fair reason for that this time, so... Usually I don't kick, but this time, yeah. Yeah, the big guy, I'll let him stay.
He's PMing me if I want all the mega capsules something. That's strange.
Yeah, let me just kick him then if he's gonna try that.
Yeah.
Okay, that leaves one more spot. And that's for Vader Zero. So I'll just wait for people to ready up. As I'm just typing in the chat, 5k euros for playing. There's one spot left. And once everyone is ready, so that's 24th Century and Vader Zero. We'll just wait for him to ready up, and then we'll start this first in-game event. I see you start with the appointment, so I'll start scoping.
Yep, that's good.
Yeah, if he's gonna take too long, I'm just gonna start. What is life? Yeah, let's just go. He's taking long enough. So, first in-game event then on E-Boat, 5k euros for playing, and after this game, we'll also host the second giveaway for tonight for the gun that I'll be playing with at the start, the ASW Betrayal for 15 days, and along with that, the Iron Set 70s. So we're together now. Should be easy carry, easy win, shouldn't it?
I hope so.
Oh, we start on defense, so that's good. I can test out the scope. You gotta watch out for them nade spots, though. Ah, wait, they're not really E-Bot players in it who know that nade spot, I think. Hitman should know it, if I'm not mistaken. There's a nade that comes here, and I don't think, yeah, see, nobody knows it. That's good. Gives us extra time. Pretty good thing that I can do here on E-Boat, wall bangs. I still didn't hit him.
Oh,
and as you can see at the wall, a lot of bullets. My aim was too high.
Oh, the clutch.
Oh, it's a mid. No, it's not mid. Whoa, the lags.
Don't let him escape. No, what you doing?
Oh my, he tanked that shot right at the end.
Return to main base.
Great. I always have such luck. I should have scoped some more though. One push through. That's something easier for me. I never let that happen. Okay, nice.
Oh! Two guys up there.
Now can actually push up on the right side. No! Why? Timing! He's slowly moving up to Bell. Just a scope. Oh, never mind. Oh, the knife! The knife! The knife!
Oh, I missed it.
There's a guy here with the sidewinder. That's interesting.
Yeah, I haven't seen that map in ages.
Enemy troops eliminated. Operation success. Return to main base. Your efforts are commended.
Oh, we gotta win now. We gotta pull it through. Yeah, one guy should be pushing at mid now. Let me play pixel spot in mid. Okay, push in mid.
Oh!
No, he just passed. Look at this spot. No!
Oh.
There we go. The spots are real. Three, two, one, peek.
Oh.
There we go.